The historic town of St. George and related fortifications is the name used by the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organizations, UNESCO, World Heritage Committee to identify collectively as a World Heritage Site the St. George's Town, founded in 1612, following the 1609 wreck on Bermuda's reefs of the Sea Venture, and a range of fortifications, batteries, and magazines built between 1612 and 1939, the last of which was removed from use in 1953. St. George's, located on the island and within the parish of the same names, is the oldest surviving English town in the New World. Originally called New London, it was founded by the Virginia Company and was Bermuda's capital until 1815. It contains many historic buildings, including St. Peter's Church, consecrated in 1612, though the oldest parts of the present structure date to 1620, the oldest Protestant church in the New World, the State House, which had housed the Parliament of Bermuda from 1620 until 1815, and many other historical buildings, including the Tucker House, the Globe Hotel, the Mitchell House, Stewart Lodge, the Old Rectory, the Bridge House, the Carriage House, and the unfinished church. Most of the forts, even those only built towards the end of the 19th century, were obsolete by the early years of the 20th century due to advances in both coastal and naval artillery, although some of the later batteries of rifled breech loaders, such as St. David's Battery, also known as the Examination Battery, remained in use as late as 1953. By then, the decision had been made to close the dockyard, withdrawing both the majority of the Royal Naval Establishment and the remaining regular army component of the Bermuda Garrison, the part-time units, the Bermuda Volunteer Rifle Corps, retitled the Bermuda Rifles, and the Bermuda Militia Artillery continued in existence without an imperial defense role, amalgamating in 1965 to form the Bermuda Regiment. In sites listed within the description of the World Heritage Site, including the town of St. George, or St. George's Town, usually referred to simply as St. George's, and the related fortifications, and batteries and magazines, follow.
The Iron Bridge Gorge is a deep gorge, containing the River Severn in Shropshire, England. It was first formed by a glacial overflow from the long-drained-away Lake Clapworth, at the end of the last ice age. The deep exposure of the rocks cut through by the gorge exposed commercial deposits of coal, iron ore, limestone and fireclay, which enabled the rapid economic development of the area during the early Industrial Revolution. Originally called the Severn Gorge, the gorge now takes its name from its famous iron bridge, the first iron bridge of its kind in the world, and a monument to the industry that began there. The bridge was built in 1779 to link the industrial town of Broseley with the smaller mining town of Madley and the growing industrial center of Coalbrookdale. There are two reasons the site was so useful to the early industrialists. The raw materials, coal, iron ore, limestone and clay, for the manufacture of iron, tiles and porcelain are exposed or easily mined in the gorge. The deep and wide river allowed easy transport of products to the sea. The gorge carries the River Severn south towards the Bristol Channel. It was formed during the last ice age when the water from the previously north-flowing river became trapped in a lake, Lake Clapworth, created when the Irish Sea ice sheet dammed the river. The lake level rose until the water flowed through the hills to the south. This flow eroded a path through the hills, forming the gorge and permanently diverting the Severn southwards. The gorge is a civil parish of Telford and Rookham Borough. It covers the part of Iron Bridge Gorge that falls within the Telford and Rookham Council area, which is most of it, and includes settlements such as Iron Bridge, Coalbrookdale and Coalport, but not Buildwas or Broseley, and part of Jackfield. It is divided into three parish wards, Lightmore, Iron Bridge, and Coalport and Jackfield. The parish council has its offices and holds its meetings at the Mosscraft Centre in Jackfield. Severn Gorge Countryside Trust manages most of the woodland, grassland and other countryside within the Iron Bridge Gorge World Heritage Site, around 260 hectares in all.
The Jurassic Coast is a World Heritage Site on the English Channel coast of southern England. It stretches from Exmouth in East Devon to Studland Bay in Dorset, a distance of about 154 kilometres, and was inscribed on the World Heritage List in mid-December 2001. The site spans 185 million years of geological history, coastal erosion having exposed an almost continuous sequence of rock formation covering the Triassic, Jurassic and Cretaceous periods. At different times, this area has been desert, shallow tropical sea and marsh, and the fossilized remains of the various creatures that lived here have been preserved in the rocks. Natural features seen on this stretch of coast include arches, pinnacles and stack rocks. In some places the sea has broken through resistant rocks to produce coves with restricted entrances, and in one place, the Isle of Portland is connected to the land by a narrow spit. In some parts of the coast, landslides are common. These have exposed a wide range of fossils, the different rock types each having its own typical fauna and flora, thus providing evidence of how animals and plants evolved in this region. The area around Lilworth Cove contains a fossil forest, and 71 different rock strata have been identified at Lyme Regis, each with its own species of ammonite. The fossil collector Mary Inning lived here, and her major discoveries of marine reptiles and other fossils were made at a time when the study of paleontology was just starting to develop. The Charnwith Heritage Coast Centre provides information on the Heritage Coast, and the whole length of the site can be visited via the Southwest Coast Path. The Jurassic Coast stretches from Morecambe Point near Exmouth in East Devon to Old Harry Rocks near Swanage in East Dorset, a distance of 154 kilometres. Inscribed on the World Heritage List in 2001, the Jurassic Coast was the first wholly natural World Heritage Site to be designated in the United Kingdom. At Morecambe Point, the GeoNeedle, 2002, an acute pyramidal sculpture, marks the western end of the heritage site. This is built out of fragments of the different types of rocks to be seen along the coast.
Kew Gardens is a botanical garden in southwest London that houses the largest and most diverse botanical and mycological collections in the world. Founded in 1840, from the exotic garden at Kew Park in the London borough of Richmond upon Thames, UK, its living collections include more than 30,000 different kinds of plants, while the herbarium, which is one of the largest in the world, has over 7 million preserved plant specimens. The library contains more than 750,000 volumes, and the illustrations collection contains more than 175,000 prints and drawings of plants. It is one of London's top tourist attractions and is a World Heritage Site. Kew Gardens, together with the Botanic Gardens at Wakehurst Place in Sussex, are managed by the Royal Botanic Gardens, Kew, brand name Kew, an internationally important botanical research and education institution that employs 750 staff and is a non-departmental public body sponsored by the Department for Environment, Food and Rural Affairs. The Kew site, which has been dated as formally starting in 1759, though it can be traced back to the exotic garden at Kew Park, formed by Lord Capel John of Tewkesbury, consists of 121 hectares of gardens and botanical glasshouses, 4 Grade I listed buildings, and 36 Grade II listed structures, all set in an internationally significant landscape. Kew Gardens has its own police force, Kew Constabulary, which has been in operation since 1847. Kew Gardens is accessible by a number of gates. Currently, there are 4 gates into Kew Gardens that are open to the public: the Elizabeth Gate, which is situated at the west end of Kew Green, and was originally called the Main Gate before being renamed in 2012 to commemorate the Diamond Jubilee of Elizabeth II, the Brentford Gate, which faces the River Thames, the Victoria Gate, named after Queen Victoria, situated in Kew Road, which is also the location of the Visitors' Centre, and the Lion Gate, also situated in Kew Road. Other gates that are not open to the public include Unicorn Gate, Cumberland Gate and Jodrell Gate, all in Kew Road, and Isleworth Gate, facing the Thames. The gardens have their own police force, Kew Constabulary, which has been in operation since 1847. Formerly known as the Royal Botanic Gardens Constabulary, It is a small, specialized constabulary of 2 sergeants and 12 officers, who patrol the grounds in a marked silver car.
Leeds Castle is in Kent, England, 8 kilometers southeast of Maidstone. A castle has been on the site since 1119. In the 13th century it came into the hands of King Edward I, for whom it became a favorite residence. In the 16th century, Henry VIII used it as a dwelling for his first wife, Catherine of Aragon. The castle today dates mostly from the 19th century and is built on islands and a lake formed by the River Lent to the east of the village of Leeds. It has been open to the public since 1976. The last private owner of the castle was the Honourable Olive, Lady Bailey, daughter of Almeric Paget, 1st Baron Queenborough, and his first wife, Pauline Payne Whitney, an American heiress. Lady Bailey bought the castle in 1926 for £180,000. On July 17, 1978, the castle was the site of a meeting between the Egyptian Foreign Minister Mohammed Ibrahim Carmel and Israeli Foreign Minister Moshe Dayan and Cyrus Vance of the USA in preparation for the Camp David Accords. The castle also hosted the Northern Ireland peace talks held in September 2004 led by Tony Blair. An aviary was added in 1980 and by 2011 it contained over 100 species, but it was decided to close it in October 2012 as it was felt the foundation could make better use of the £200,000 a year it cost to keep the aviary running. The castle and its grounds are a major leisure destination with a maze that is exited through a shell grotto, a golf course and what may be the world's only museum of dog collars. There are 2 castle-themed children's adventure play areas targeted at the under-7s and the under-14s. It is a Grade I listed building, first listed in 1952, and recognized as an internationally important structure. In 1998 Leeds Castle was one of 57 heritage sites in England to receive more than 200,000 visitors. According to figures released by the Association of Leading Visitor Attractions, nearly 564,483 people visited the castle in 2015. However, visitor numbers fell by 30% in July 2015 as a result of Operation Stack on the M20 during the migrants' crisis in Calais. The grounds of Leeds Castle are crisscrossed by a network of public footpaths. Some follow the course of the River Lent while others radiate from the church in Leeds Village.
The Library of Birmingham is a public library in Birmingham, England. It is situated on the west side of the city centre at Centenary Square, beside the Birmingham Rep and Baskerville House. Upon opening on September 3, 2013, it replaced Birmingham Central Library. The library, which is estimated to have cost £188.8 million, is viewed by the Birmingham City Council as a flagship project for the city's redevelopment. It has been described as the largest public library in the United Kingdom, the largest public cultural space in Europe, and the largest regional library in Europe. The library has nationally and internationally significant collections, including the Boulton and Watt Archives, the Bourneville Village Trust Archive, the Charles Parker Archive, the Parker Collection of Children's Books, the Wingate Bet Transport Ticket Collection, the Railway and Canal Historical Society Library, and the Photographic Archives of the Warwickshire Photographic Survey, Sir Benjamin Stone, John Blakemore and Val Williams, and is in the process of acquiring that of Daniel Meadows. The Specialist Shakespeare Memorial Room was designed in 1882 by John Henry Chamberlain for the first central library. When the old building was demolished in 1974, Chamberlain's room was dismantled and later fitted into the new concrete shell of the new library complex. When the Library of Birmingham was built, it was again moved to the top floor. It houses Britain's most important Shakespeare collection, and one of the 2 most important Shakespeare collections in the world, the other being held by the Folger Shakespeare Library. The collection contains 43,000 books, including rare items such as a copy of the first folio 1,623, copies of the four earliest folio editions, over 70 editions of separate plays printed before 1709, including three paper quartos published in 1619 but falsely dated. There are significant collections from the 18th, 19th, and 20th centuries, a near-complete collection of collected works, significant numbers of adaptations, anthologies, and individual editions. The Boulton and Watt Collection is the archive of the steam engine partnership of Matthew Boulton and James Watt, dating from its formation in 1774 until the firm's closure in the 1890s. The archive comprises about 550 volumes of letters, books, order books, and account books, approximately 29,000 engine drawings, and upwards of 20,000 letters received from customers.
The Liverpool Maritime Mercantile City is a UNESCO-designated World Heritage Site in Liverpool, England. It comprises six locations in the city centre of Liverpool, including the Pierhead, Albert Dock, and William Brown Street, and includes many of the city's most famous landmarks, each of which relates to a different component in time in the Liverpool's maritime history. The inscripted sites extend for approximately 4 kilometers north-south along the city's waterfront and stretch approximately 1 kilometer east-west. In total, it covers an area of 136 hectares. UNESCO received the City Council's nomination for the six sites in January 2003, and in September of that year sent ECOMO's representatives to carry out an evaluation on the eligibility for these areas to be given World Heritage status. In March 2004, ECOMOS recommended that UNESCO inscribe the Liverpool Maritime Mercantile City as a World Heritage Site. The area was inscribed during the 28th session of the World Heritage Committee in 2004 under cultural criteria IE, E and IF. Its inclusion by UNESCO was attributed to the fact that it was the supreme example of a commercial port at a time of Britain's greatest global influence. In 2012, the site was inscribed on the list of World Heritage Endangered due to the proposed construction of Liverpool Waters Project. It is one of only two endangered World Heritage Sites in Europe. The second endangered site are medieval monuments in Kosovo. In July 2017, UNESCO warned that the city's status as a World Heritage Site was at risk of being rescinded in light of planning and development proposals, with English Heritage asserting that the proposed Liverpool Waters development would leave the setting of some of Liverpool's most significant historic buildings severely compromised, the archaeological remains of parts of the historic docks at risk of destruction, and the city's historic urban landscape permanently unbalanced.
London Zoo is the world's oldest scientific zoo. It was opened in London on April 27, 1828, and was originally intended to be used as a collection for scientific study. In 1831 or 1832, the animals of the Tower of London Menagerie were transferred to the zoo's collection. It was eventually opened to the public in 1847. Today it houses a collection of 698 species of animals, with 20,166 individuals, making it one of the largest collections in the United Kingdom. The zoo is sometimes called Regent's Zoo. It is managed under the aegis of the Zoological Society of London, established in 1826, and is situated at the northern edge of Regent's Park, on the boundary line between the city of Westminster and the borough of Camden. The Regent's Canal runs through it. The Society also has a more spacious site at ZSL Whitesnade Zoo in Bedfordshire, to which the larger animals such as elephants and rhinos have been moved. As well as being the first scientific zoo, ZSL London Zoo also opened the first reptile house, 1849, first public aquarium, 1853, first insect house, 1881, and the first children's zoo, 1938. ZSL receives no state funding and relies on fellows and friends memberships, entrance fees and sponsorship to generate income. Land of the Lions is a new enclosure for ZSL London Zoo's Asiatic Lions, which opened in spring 2016 by Queen Elizabeth II. Tiger Territory is ZSL London Zoo Sumatran Tiger Enclosure, designed by architect Michael Cosden and officially opened by HRH, Duke of Edinburgh in March 2013. There has been an aquarium at the zoo since 1853. The zoo's first aquarium was also the world's first public aquarium. The current aquarium was built in 1921 next to the Mappin Terraces, and was officially opened by King George V and his wife Queen Mary in April 1924. Animal Adventure opened in 2009 and is an area aimed primarily at children, featuring playgrounds and a water fountain. Many of the animals in Animal Adventure are domestic animals, such as sheep, donkeys, llamas, alpacas, goats and ferrets, as well as rare breeds such as silky chickens, Rex rabbits and Cunac-coon pigs. Other notable animals in London Zoo's collection include black vultures, greater flamingos, vicunas, Bactrian camels, spectacled owls, red-ruffed lemurs, African harrier hawks, Malayan tapirs, burrowing owls, white-cheeked gibbons, military macaws, oriental small-clawed otters, reindeer, giant anteaters, Rupel's vultures, Bornean bearded pigs, Rodriguez fruit bats and great white pelicans. Greenwich is an area of southeast London, England, located 8.9 kilometers east-southeast of Charing Cross. It is located within the Royal Borough of Greenwich, to which it lends its name. Greenwich is notable for its maritime history and for giving its name to the Greenwich Meridian and Greenwich Mean Time. The town became the site of a royal palace, the Palace of Placentia from the 15th century, and was the birthplace of many Tudors, including Henry VIII and Elizabeth I. The palace fell into disrepair during the English Civil War and was rebuilt as the Royal Naval Hospital for Sailors by Sir Christopher Wren and his assistant Nicholas Hawksmoor. These buildings became the Royal Naval College in 1873, and they remained an establishment for military education until 1998 when they passed into the hands of the Greenwich Foundation. The historic rooms within these buildings remain open to the public. Other buildings are used by University of Greenwich and Trinity Laban Conservatoire of Music and Dance. The town became a popular resort in the 18th century and many grand houses were built there, such as Vanbrugh Castle, 1717, established on Maze Hill, next to the park. From the Georgian period, estates of houses were constructed above the town center. The maritime connections of Greenwich were celebrated in the 20th century, with the sighting of the Cutty Sark and Gypsy Moth 4 next to the riverfront, and the National Maritime Museum in the former buildings of the Royal Hospital School in 1934. Greenwich formed part of Kent until 1889 when the County of London was created. In 1997, Maritime Greenwich was added to the list of World Heritage Sites, for the concentration and quality of buildings of historic and architectural interest. These can be divided into the group of buildings along the riverfront, Greenwich Park and the Georgian and Victorian Town Centre. Greenwich Heritage Centre is a museum and local history resource run by the Royal Borough of Greenwich, and is based in Artillery Square, in the Royal Arsenal, Woolwich, southeast London. The Discover Greenwich Visitor Center provides an introduction to the history and attractions in the Greenwich World Heritage Site. It is located in the Pepys Building near to the Cutty Sark within the grounds of the old Royal Naval College, formerly Greenwich Hospital. The building began life as an engineering laboratory for the college. The center opened in March 2010, and admission is free.
The National Gallery is an art museum in Trafalgar Square in the city of Westminster, in central London. Founded in 1824, it houses a collection of over 2,300 paintings dating from the mid-13th century to 1900. The gallery is an exempt charity and a non-departmental public body of the Department for Culture, Media, and Sport. Its collection belongs to the government on behalf of the British public, and entry to the main collection is free of charge. It is among the most visited art museums in the world, after the Louvre, the British Museum, and the Metropolitan Museum of Art. Unlike comparable museums in continental Europe, the National Gallery was not formed by nationalizing an existing royal or princely art collection. It came into being when the British government bought 38 paintings from the heirs of John Julius Angerstein, an insurance broker and patron of the arts, in 1824. After that initial purchase, the gallery was shaped mainly by its early directors, notably Sir Charles Lockie Slake, and by private donations, which comprise two-thirds of the collection. The resulting collection is small in size, compared with many European national galleries, but encyclopedic in scope. Most major developments in Western painting from Giotto to Cezanne are represented with important works. It used to be claimed that this was one of the few national galleries that had all its works on permanent exhibition, but this is no longer the case. The present building, the third to house the National Gallery, was designed by William Wilkins from 1832 to 1838. Only the facade onto Trafalgar Square remains essentially unchanged from this time, as the building has been expanded piecemeal throughout its history. Wilkins' building was often criticized for the perceived weaknesses of its design and for its lack of space. The latter problem led to the establishment of the Tate Gallery for British Art in 1897. The Sainsbury Wing, an extension to the west by Robert Venturi and Denise Scott Brown, is a notable example of postmodernist architecture in Britain. In 2014, the National Gallery was the subject of a documentary film by Frederick Wiseman. The film shows the gallery administration and staff at work, the conservation laboratory, docent tours, and the mounting of Leonardo da Vinci, J.M.W. Turner, and Titian exhibitions in 2011-2012.